Hi guys, I'm Harry and tonight I'm going to be teaching you about polynomials. So, what is a polynomial? Well, a polynomial is an expression that consists of a constant, a variable and a positive integer exponent that can all be combined using addition, subtraction and multiplication. So I just want to go over the point there that the positive integer exponent, this is really important because if the exponent is a negative value, then it's not a polynomial. So here we have x squared. The square is a positive value, so that means that it is a polynomial. Here we have x to the power of minus 2, which means that it is not a polynomial. So, where does the word polynomial come from? Well, poly is the Greek word for many, and in this case, nominal means terms, so many terms. It originated in the 17th century and it has Greek roots. So now you know what a polynomial is. I'll just go through some examples here to clear some things up. So here we have 7, 4x plus 3, x squared minus 3x plus 2, 2x cubed minus 5x squared, x to the power of 4 plus 3x minus 2. Now, these are all polynomial expressions. So let me just break that a little bit further for you. So over here we have another polynomial expression. We have x squared plus 2x plus 5. So, the 5 is the constant in this case. The constant meaning that the value will never change. If the variable changes, then the constant will always remain the same. In the middle we have the 2x, which the x in this case is the variable. Over here we have the exponent, note that it's a positive value to the power of 2. That's the exponent. Here we have the what's known as the leading term, which in a polynomial expression will always be the highest exponent. So what can we tell from the leading term? Well, we can decipher what degree the polynomial expression is. So over here we have x squared minus 3x plus 2. This is a second degree polynomial expression because it's x to the power of 2. We have 2x cubed is a third degree polynomial expression because it's to the power of 3. And we have x to the power of 4, which is a fourth degree polynomial expression. Now for the smaller polynomial expressions, meaning the smaller exponents, we have names for the polynomial expressions. So here we have x squared minus 3x plus 2. This is what's known as a quadratic equation because it's to the power of 2. We have 2x to the power of 3 minus 5x squared. This is a cubic equation. We have x to the power of 4 plus 3x minus 2. This is a quartic equation. Now we also have more names for the expressions depending on the amount of terms that are in the expression. So here we have 7, which is a monomial expression, mono meaning 1. Here we have 4x plus 3, which is a binomial expression, bi meaning 2. And we have x squared minus 3x plus 2 is a trinomial expression because it has 3 terms here, tri meaning 3. So, now you know what these are, I'd just like to go over some key points to remember. So, the positive exponent is an important thing to remember because, like I said earlier, if it's a negative value, then it's not a polynomial. The terms should be in descending order, which means that the largest exponent should be at the beginning, so x to the power of 4, that is the largest exponent here, that is the leading term. And also, which is very basic algebra, is 2x is not x squared, which means that whatever the value of x is, 2x means that x is multiplied by 2, whereas x squared means that the value of x is multiplied by itself. So, thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope it helps you with your studies. Thanks.